Hi, I'm Jian Hu from MD Anderson Cancer Center. Today, I'm going to introduce our paper recently published in JCI regarding lipid metabolism in mature myelin. Myelin, which is shown here in the brown wrap, is a specialized multi-layer membrane structure that enables rapid nerve conduction. And it is assembled by oligodendrocytes in the central nervous system. The dry mass of central nervous system myelin is composed of approximately 75% of lipids and 25% of proteins, a composition that is characterized by a very high ratio of lipids to proteins. For decades, mature myelin has been considered as a very stable material. For instance, a series of studies suggested that, quote, "It seems that the myelin lipids may remain indefinitely in the nerve sheaths where they were laid down originally during the development of the central nervous system," unquote, meaning that once the mature myelin has formed, it stays unchanged. And later studies also suggested that myelin proteins are extremely long-lived proteins which did not turn over in post-mitotic cells of the rat central nervous system. However, surprisingly, we found that mature myelin is in fact a very dynamic material, especially its lipid components. We have been studying a gene called quaking, or QKI, which is a tumor suppressor in brain tumor and a regulator of lipid metabolism. We reasoned that if mature myelin is a stable material, knockout of quaking in mature oligodendrocytes shouldn't affect myelin integrity because we have shown that knockout quaking did not cause cell death since it is a tumor suppressor. However, we found knockout of quaking in mature oligodendrocytes in 8 weeks or older mice leads to severe demyelination without affecting oligodendrocyte survival, as well as myelin protein levels such as MAG shown here. What is changed dramatically is the myelin lipid level indicated by fluoromyelin staining. These data indicated that mature myelin is a very dynamic material with fast turnover of its lipid components. To reinforce the importance of continuous lipid supply in myelin maintenance, we could partially restore the myelin lipid content by feeding quaking knockout animals high-fat diet, and consequently, we could alleviate the demyelinating symptoms and extend the survivals of these animals. To explore the mechanism underpinning the regulation of lipid metabolism by quaking, we discovered that unlike its canonical function as RNA binding protein, quaking 5 actually very tightly interacts with the chromatin, and it forms a very tight complex with PPAR beta and RXR alpha. And we further demonstrated that quaking functions as a coactivator of PPAR beta RXR alpha to enhance the transcription activity for lipid metabolic genes. Because we found quaking is a coactivator of PPAR beta RXR alpha, we reasoned that if we can activate PPAR beta RXR alpha through their agonists, we might be able to rescue the demyelinating phenotypes of quaking knockout. And that turns out to be the case. We found that our PPAR beta agonist KD3010 could restore the myelin content and greatly extend the lifespan of quaking knockout mice. Similarly, we found that an RXR alpha agonist bexorotin could also restore the myelin content and greatly extend the lifespan of quaking knockout mice. To explore the clinical relevance of our findings, we checked a cohort of primary progressive multiple sclerosis patients and found that in their lesions, lipid contents but not the protein contents, were dramatically reduced, indicating that at least a subset of MS could be a lipid defective disease. In summary, we found that mature myelin is indeed a very dynamic material with a very fast turnover of its lipid components. Quaking pipa beta RXR alpha is a major regulator of lipid metabolism in mature myelin maintenance. Without the proper function of quaking pipa beta RXR alpha and lipid supply, although oligodendrocytes are still alive, they cannot meet the great demand of lipid turnover in mature myelin.